since he didn't fight, now he's saying that he may go in April. Right. The elephant in the room is that Crawford fight. Do you think that it's a possibility that we can see that in 2023 at all?
I don't know. I mean, I think that, like I said before, when the Brian Custer interview, his perspective of himself didn't work this much. But that's not what the only really good, and you're worth everything you say you are, but in reality, from a business perspective, you're not worth that because the numbers say it all. And I don't think that he'll ever say anything. Picture like saying I'm this. I'm running your 15,000 pages you bought. You're not gonna say that. That guy, that's $600,000. Like, he's not gonna say that. So I think that, I don't know. Don't have the conversation.
Well, if you don't get that fight, Coach, do you think it's possible that Earl, we'll see Earl move up to 154 this year?
No, man. Christmas might come early.
I will say this, Coach. All of us like to play matchmaker. We know that there's a guy out there in Brian Castaño that did beat Earl in the Olympics or in the amateurs.
So what are you saying?
That would be a great fight, Coach.
For Earl and Brian Castaño?
Great fight.
Now, he beat him in the Olympics. It was like some junior tournament when I first started training.
Okay.
And I didn't train him. We trained with the Olympic training camp or whatever. So it's different.
So with that history, you don't think that'd be a good storyline to go?
Yeah. Had he won the fight against Jamel Charlo, it would have been a good fight.
Wait,
knocked out by Jamel Charlo, it's nothing.
So are you saying it's not even going to be a competitive fight? Is that what you're saying?
I was just saying, you don't think Castaño's going to be a competitive fight? First of all, let me tell you what it was. When I realized in the first fight when I watched it again, Castaño was too small. The physicality wasn't big enough to sign up for Jamel. So over time, and what it was is Castaño's trainer, his family, his comfort, all did him a disservice. They kept telling him how he won the first fight. That's what he was focused on, is how he won the first fight. He didn't remember how Jamel rocked him, how much Jamel was stronger than he was, how he started breaking out. That's the part that they kind of like manipulated him to forget about. So when he got in the ring, it was like, over time, you want to see him break down. He just wasn't strong enough, just wasn't physical enough. And when he hit him with the shot, he just dropped real slow. And it just all, so he forgot about all that until he got in the ring. Damn, now I remember. And being honest, I mean, when you watch him, I watch the play, he's just like, just breaking down. Being honest.
How is Jamel? Just curious. I know he's good.
Do
we have an idea of maybe when that fight will get rescheduled?
I don't know.
You know,